Hi everyone, so today we're going to look at installing IntelliJ on Windows 10. So we'll go to your favorite search engine and type in JetBrains Toolbox, and we'll start by installing the toolbox that allows for IntelliJ to be installed. Now you can install the Windows version of IntelliJ or the Mac version of IntelliJ using the direct link to IntelliJ from JetBrains, or you can do it through the toolbox. I like the toolbox because it's easy to do upgrades and updates, and if you want to install other JetBrains tools, then that works too. Okay, so we've got the toolbox coming in right now. I'm going to accept right here, and I'm going to choose the Community Edition of IntelliJ to install. All right, so it's downloading right now. I've sped this up a little bit. It takes a little while on my tablet. Here we go, so it's installing. And then once it's in, then we'll load up IntelliJ. Okay, so we're gonna open it up. You can see that there's options to uninstall from the toolbox, but here, I just click on the main part right here, and we've got 2021 version 3. We agree to the terms. And here we go. So I'm going to start a new project, and I'm going to load in or download the JDK for version 17, okay, of the Java JDK from Oracle. So open JDK 17.0.1 in this particular case. There are other options out there, but we're going to try it out on Oracle's version of the JDK. So I'm starting the project. I've now downloaded the JDK. I click through and I type in the project for my project. Here's the name for my project. Okay. Now I'm going to click over here and go into the source folder for my project. I'm going to right click. I'm going to say new. And I'm going to have a new package. So I'm going to call the package ECS1021 because that's the course, but I could call it something else if I wanted to. And I'm going to add a new class to the package. There you go. You can see the package name right there, and you can see the name of the class as well. So public class, my first class. My first class is the name of my class, and I will put a main method inside of my class. Now, how do I write a main method in Java inside the class? Well, it's got a couple of different keywords in it, so I'm just going to do a quick little search right here. I'm going to say main in Java, and I'll find a tutorial page, and the end result will be public static void main string args like this. But the Java T point reference page is pretty good for this, just in case you forget it. Now I do all the time. So I scroll down to find a good example. Scroll, scroll, scroll. Search engines are great for finding the keywords that you need. All right, so I'm going to select this, copy and paste, and put it into my project. All right, so I'm going to head back over to IntelliJ. Right here. And inside of my class, I'm going to paste in the opening for my main method. Okay, so methods are like functions if you've programmed in MATLAB or C or one of these other languages. I've pasted it in. Now I put in some curly braces like this. And then I type in S out as the shortcut for system out print line. So S out and then enter. And now I'm going to type in the thing that I want printed as part of my program. Okay, then I'm going to head over to the hammer for compiling, that green hammer up there. And so it's going to compile, And then when I'm ready, I'm going to click on one of those green green triangles, not arrows, green triangles that appeared on the left, right there. Okay, so I'm going to click on that triangle and I'm going to run my program. And you'll see a console will pop up. At the bottom, that will show the result of my, see, it's running right now. So it's gonna run and the result is right there. Hello, this is my first Java program, right there. So my program has run, it's worked out. There you have it, your first Java program. Right, there you go.